This meeting was called. You recall that we had a meeting on the 30th of December 2019. And today we held another one. And the whole essence of the meeting is to critically evaluate what the armed forces of Nigeria, as well as other security agents, security and intelligence agencies are doing with regards to ensuring that the territorial integrity of Nigeria is not undermined by any individual or group of individuals. And the appraisal also looked at the emerging situations in some of our areas, particularly the acts of banditry in some of the northern, northwestern states and other parts of the country. And we have critically looked at everything, and we are satisfied with the progress we are making. We are satisfied with the support that the federal government is giving the armed forces and other security agencies in terms of procurement of platforms. Substantial number of this equipment are expected by the end of February. Some of the equipment we are acquiring have started arriving. For the Nigerian Air Force, two helicopter gunships have arrived on the 15th of January, and we are now in the process of putting them together, which will add to whatever we have. We are equally, of course, expecting other equipment, like I said, that are meant for the armed forces of Nigeria, which we are hoping to get by end of February. I'm sure you're also aware of policy on community policing that was approved by Mr. President and is going to be funded. And the whole idea is to ensure that Nigeria is secured and Nigerians can go about pursuing their legitimate aspirations without any hindrance. I think basically that is what this meeting is all about. And what we want to do here is to reassure Nigerians that the armed forces of Nigeria, and indeed security and intelligence agencies in Nigeria, are going to continue to work round the clock to ensure that our country is secured and to ensure that nobody undermines the territorial integrity of national sovereignty of Nigeria. We are going to keep a very close watch on what is going on. And with the equipment that we are getting, definitely the challenges we are facing in some of the theaters of operation, particularly the Northeast, will be addressed adequately. We are doing everything with other sister countries in the Lake Chad Basin, working together to ensure that the the Boko Haram terrorism is brought substantially to an end as much as possible, as quickly as possible. I think our appeal is for all Nigerians and other stakeholders to join hands with the armed forces of Nigeria and other security and intelligence agencies to ensure that our country is secured, rather than looking at other methods that are likely going to negate national policing and community policing policy that the federal government has approved. What we expect is for all stakeholders, local governments, state governments, other stakeholders, to join hands with us and let us work together to ensure that our country is secure. I think with these few remarks, I want to thank you for giving us. All right.